Hello and welcome to my devlog. This is the second video and today I will be adding all my models into Unity 3D. And I will try to make a controllable character. First of all, I needed to check my model's pivot points and fix them if necessary. Then I checked my model's names. Naming your assets is very important because it's gonna be hard looking for a specific one if you have lots of them. I found a couple of new ones that I actually made for a so-called art jam, where we made some art in a few hours, and I thought that I could use these models somewhere in my game, so I decided to keep them and gave them proper names. After checking all models, I exported them as FBX files. Now it was time to add everything into Unity 3D. I made some new folders so that everything would have a proper place to be. I have also checked my texture, which by the way is the only one for all my environment models. Right now there is a lot of free space here, but it will be filled someday. I used a PSD file format for my texture so I could easily fix any mistakes. However, when I used it on my models, there was a strange white edge along the transparent parts. Also, as you can see, I am using an unlit shader because I am not planning to use any light source. So anyway, I needed to get rid of this bright edge somehow. At first I have used an unlit transparent cutout shader, where the transparent part would be sharp but not smooth, and I didn't really like this, but it's more or less okay for now. Then I applied this material to all my models and created prefabs. Somehow I couldn't just create all the prefabs by dragging all my models from the scene, so it took some time to do this one by one. I still didn't like this sharp transparency, so I decided to go back to a simple transparency and to check the texture settings, and I noticed that there was a possibility to remove matte from PSD. So I checked it. I didn't really know what it means, but I still tried it and it worked. The bright edge was gone. However, I have noticed a new problem. Now all my models were transparent in places where they shouldn't be. For example, you might have noticed that the whole entrance of the catacomb is visible, so I had no options but to go back and use transparent cutout shader again. When all my environment models were prepared, I went to check my character and exported it to Unity 3D as well. My character has a different texture, so I created a new material and imported my character's texture. After this, I have visually checked the height of my character and decided to increase it because she was too short. Now I had to check the rig. First, I have picked a humanoid rig and immediately saw some kind of an error. When I checked the configuration, some bones were missing, so I had to manually add them to the correct places and enforce a T-pose. I have configured a first animation which is an idle, but before testing it I had to create an animator controller which would be applied to my character, and I added the first animation to my animator. Finally, I could check if it works, and it does. Now it was finally time to create a terrain. I started from grass blocks and decided to make a group of them. I have placed them to an empty object and made a new prefab. After this, I wanted to start playing with NavMesh. This was my first time and I was very excited to test it. I have added a new object to the grass group, which was a simple plane, and I would use this plane for NavMesh. Now you might be wondering, why wouldn't I simply use those blocks, because the nav mesh could still calculate and bake the area. However, some of those blocks were placed a little bit lower to make this kind of randomness to a terrain. At least to me it looks more interesting, and I think the baked area would also be wavy. I needed it to be flat so my character wouldn't go up and down while it was running. I have added some kind of transparent material, it didn't even matter what kind, as long as the plane is invisible. After this I have baked the area and it worked. I have added a nav mesh engine to my character and created a first script for it. The script is used to make my character move to a destination, which in this case would be some kind of an object. I created a sphere as a destination, placed it on my character script and hit play. The character turns to a destination and travels. So everything seems to be okay. I configured the turning acceleration and speed, as well as movement speed, because it looked slow at first. Then I placed another grass terrain group, and after testing I have noticed that the camera doesn't follow my character, so I created a new script which would make my character and the shadow follow her. I have used an empty object again to make a group for the camera and the shadow and applied the script to it. And did it work? Not this time, but luckily this problem was simple. My character was also in the same group, so all I had to do is to remove it. And that's it, now it works. After this I placed a running animation to my animator, made transitions between both animations, and also added a condition to change the animation. Now I had to update my character script so that the condition would change. And the simplest way for this to happen is to calculate the distance between a character and the destination. If it was big enough, then my character should start running. After I tested it, the character wouldn't run and I didn't know what to do. Then after thinking about it, I have accidentally noticed that a character would actually start running and I realized that I had to uncheck the exit time, which plays an animation until it ends before starting a new animation, and that fixed the problem. So at this point I was almost happy with the result. All I needed was to add some objects for my character to avoid, so I added the big stone and baked nav mesh again. And this time I'm fully happy because the character avoids the object well enough. The only small problem is that after she comes close to this object, she slows down and I don't like it at all. I tried changing the settings of nav mesh agent. I noticed that there was some kind of obstacle avoidance quality, so I just turned it off and it worked. Now the character moves smoothly. Then I decided to add a hair for my character because it looks a bit odd right now. At this point I was ready to create navigation on the terrain without this extra destination sphere, so I wrote a new script. Now I was able to click on any block and it would become a new destination. Now my stone needed a collider because right now I could press on a block that is under the stone and my character would try to go there but wouldn't be able to. So the collider that I created for my stone prevents this from happening. Next I decided to create a new group of terrain. I made many different variations. These groups made it easier to create a specific land. I didn't want to make randomly generated land similar to Minecraft because my game has a story and I need specific places. However, I will have dungeons which probably will be generated randomly. Making these groups took quite a while, but now it's so much easier to make a land. I tried to make a quick land just for testing. Later I will do it differently. Now I could walk wherever I wanted and it really felt great to see such a progress. I have added a catacomb building just to test bigger object for my character to avoid. By the way, it will be possible to enter it later. There were some mistakes as you can see, but I have fixed them. Now I wanted to add a pillar with a torch on top. I don't really know how it's called, but anyway, I wanted to have this object just to see how the flame looks like. I have downloaded a free version of an asset from the Unity Asset Store and used it for my model. I kind of like the result, but the style is different. What do you think? Does it look good or should I choose something else? After this, I have updated my prefabs and began making road groups. I have saved them in my prefab sets and expanded my level. I'm still not sure how big my map should be, so I'm just testing. This land might look big, but my character can actually run across it in 15 seconds. Of course, when there will be a lot of obstacles and enemies, this will take much longer, so for now I'm keeping this size. Now I wanted to make some groups of trees, and again I'm placing an additional object, which in this case is a cylinder, to use it for nav mesh baking. I have also placed a shadow to make it more realistic. I also added a collider, so my character would not try to go inside the forest. I have also added some flowers and stones to add some colors, because right now it's just green and brown everywhere. After I finished this group, I started making another one which was smaller, just to have more variation. So now everything works very well. All I wanted to do now is add some fog, so that it would be clear which objects are closer to the camera and which are farther. Making a fog was also new to me, so it took a bit of time to understand it. Also, I have added an additional texture for my camera, so that the corners would be a little bit darker. And this is the result. I think it looks pretty good, and I hope you like the result so far. However, I already used all my forest models and the map would look a bit empty. So I have decided to make new models, like new blocks of dirt and water, different kinds of mushrooms, some berries, additional grass models, some fallen branches and trees, also a campfire, a tent and a simple chest. Some of these items from this list are made for my story, because the first mission that my character will have is to gather some food, which is some berries and some mushrooms. So in the future I will also be making new animations and an inventory system. Next video will going to be all about making models. And that's it for today. I hope you liked this video and I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day!